This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. A shoot will grow up from the stem of Jesse. A branch will sprout from his roots. The Lord's Spirit will rest upon him, a spirit of wisdom and understanding, a spirit of planning and strength, a spirit of knowledge and fear of the Lord. He will delight in fearing the Lord. He won't judge by appearances nor decide by hearsay. He will judge the needy with righteousness and decide with equity for those who suffer in the land. He will strike the violent with the rod of his mouth. By the breath of his lips, he will slay the wicked. Righteousness will be the belt around his hips, and faithfulness the belt around his waist. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. So on February 13th, this coming Saturday, the Episcopal Church celebrates the life and ministry of Absalom Jones, a very important individual in our history. For he was the first priest of African descent to be ordained in the Episcopal Church. Absalom was born in 1746 in Delaware, and he was born into slavery. He was a house servant in his earliest years. And then he was sold to a businessman in Philadelphia. And it was during his time in Philadelphia that he became increasingly involved in a church called St. George's Methodist Episcopal Church. And during his time at St. George's, he learned that he had a calling, that he was really good at being a minister. And during his time there, the congregation grew in size. Many, many slaves and free blacks came to this congregation. But sadly, it made the white congregants nervous. And where they had been welcome before, they decided to build a balcony and said, all the black worshipers need to go up there now. And Absalom Jones was not okay with this, and he and several of his friends left St. George's to start their own society, the Free African Society. And it was while they were there in this group that had forcibly been ejected basically from their home, their church home, that Absalom created St. Thomas Episcopal Church. And during this season of his life, as he was exploring vocation to ministry, he was eventually ordained as the first black priest in the Episcopal Church on September 21st, 1802. We can celebrate his example and his life and his amazing deeds, but we can also ask ourselves why it took so long. Why it took so long for the Episcopal Church that had been on these shores since 1607, took them almost 200 years to ordain the first black priest. When we remember the legacy of people like Absalom, it's always good in the midst of celebration to ask ourselves those kinds of questions and to wonder how we can make good on their examples. To say, looking around, what are we still sitting on? What work remains to be done? So that we don't have to say it took too long, because it has taken too long in so many ways for us to recognize equity in our common life. And so we celebrate the example of Absalom and so many others, not only in Black History Month, but as often as we can, to remind ourselves that there has been good work done and there's still much, much good work remaining. I invite you also to check out the wonderful video that will be shared along with chapel today, that is Deborah Nelson Link, an author, reading her beautiful book. And yes, it is a for younger readers book, but it's just a wonderful story. So I invite you all to check that out if you get a chance. Thank you and amen. I invite you all into a spirit of prayer to name before God your joys and your concerns. Of course, we pray for all those in our community who are sick. Pray for speedy recovery and mild symptoms. Pray for their families, their parents taking care of them. and set us free, O God, from every bond of prejudice and fear, that honoring the steadfast courage of your servant Absalom Jones, we may show forth in our lives the reconciling love and true freedom of the children of God, which you have given us and your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And let us join those prayers with the prayer our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Our God is an awesome God.
Blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you this day and always. Amen.